everyone. I'm MikeMoneyGMR here, and welcome back to more Let's Re-Show Off. Nah, I'm just kidding. I do want to really call it that, though. Let's Re-Show Off Dragon Quest Swords. I'm not saying the whole name because it's hellaciously long and I've already forgotten. Anyway, I could look it up, but I'm not going to. I wanted to show off the item menu, so right now, you have no items or materials. So, just keep that in mind. You can also look at your sword and weapon, your sword and shield if you want. You have a copper shield, it does 15. I was way off. Okay, shut up. And you also have your shield. Durability. Okay, here's something interesting. Durability means how many hits it can take before it breaks. Now, what that means is you have, okay, here, let me go to my status real quick, because that'll show it a little bit better. So you have 100% durability for your shield. Now you have this area, and this area, all that can be destroyed until all you have left is the very, very middle of the shield. Now, I forget when it is that you learn this, but your shield can take only two or three hits or something like that in this area until it's totally destroyed, and then all you have left is this. And what that means is you have a very small window to block yourself, like, you know, defend yourself. The thing that's really bad about that is that even though this won't take any damage if you your shield won't take any damage if you hit here, which is a good thing because then you at least have something to protect yourself, it's actually a lot smaller than you would think. And say, like, if the character was, like, aiming here and you accidentally aim, like, right here with your shield, you're gonna get hit. Even if, like, a tiny little bubble of it's in there, you still get hit. So just keep that in mind. The other thing, you can also look at your attacks you have here if you want. So there's all what's in the attributes. And miscellaneous just lets you change, you know, similar things. So this is what caused problems with that one episode of Lost in Shadow. You see, this is aspect ratio of 16:9. So this is actually the first game I've played on the Wii that's actually in an aspect ratio of 16:9. Because I've done my recordings and I put it in 16:9 the way that the game says it is, and it still cuts off the top and bottom, so I don't know. I mean, tell me, viewers, in the comments. Hopefully this comes out, because I really don't want to have to do this again. But tell me in the comments, if I put this in 6, like, you know, well, I'm probably already going to be doing it, but how many Wii games actually were in 16:9? Do you know? I mean, I could probably look it up right now and save myself the trouble and save you guys the trouble, but I want to give you guys the option to look it up for me, because it'd be more enjoyable that way. Basically, I want you guys to just say, hey, it's actually this many games, like pretty much every Wii game. You could say that if it's the truth. Say every Wii game was released in 16:9, and then that wouldn't bother me. Because, like I was saying, you know, in 4:3, which is full screen, technically, like, if you switch it to it, actually, it doesn't look that bad. I don't know, what do you guys think? It looks pretty good, but I don't know, I mean, it kind of compacts it. So I don't know, I mean, I guess putting it in that, it would come out better if I do 4:3, but the first episode would be in 16, whatever. So I don't know. I'll leave it to what it is, what it was before. Or it just looks a little bit less compact. You got your volume and all that. You can actually change it where characters never talk. And I don't know if this means only in, like, dialogues, because if I put it down to, like, say 3, and you talk to Prince analysts a whole bunch and he does his mumbling, you probably don't hear him at all, so I don't know. Music's always the same. So, yeah. You can also change your Wii Remote audio to have it where the Wii Remote will play certain sound effects. You probably won't hear them, because I think I tried to put it into the thing, and well, since the thing didn't go through, I don't know if I heard it or not. But basically, I just put, like, you're probably getting an echo from me now, but I put the mic from the Wiimote up to the mic and was like, here you go, see if you can hear this. And I tested one of the sound effects, and I don't think it came through because it's really quiet. I mean, I could put it through the TV so you can hear it, but I don't know. I won't for now, but we'll see. You can also get your tutorials that you've seen. I don't know why they gave us number 1 and number 2. Whatever. I'm totally disappointed that Mother wasn't able to witness your splendid display of swordsmanship earlier, Mike. When she has recovered, we must make up for it by staging a little duel of our own in her presence. Okay, whatever. Oh, by the way... Actually, here, let me see if I can make this go through the television. Because I want you to kind of get... Because I don't know if you hear it through the television. But here, I want you to listen to the sounds of the steps if it does it. Out here. Let's see. It doesn't. Well, not that you can hear it, at least. I know, I'm just running around to see if I can hear it. I don't know, you guys might hear it better than me. I'm gonna change it back to the remote, because it's more fun to actually hear it than the remote. I will say this much. The Wii Remote playing the sounds of your footfalls and stuff is kind of neat. That's basically what it's doing. But it's very quiet. There's certain things that you step on that sound louder, but whatever. Okay. Oh yeah, I remember him. Yeah, right, I doubt that. You know, you want to search these barrels. One of them has an item in it. I can't remember which one. There it is, mini metal. In later Dragon Quest games for, I don't remember what system it was, mini metals were actually useful for, like, special events. So, yeah, I don't remember what it is. You're free to remind me if you want. H.C. Bailey would know. Okay, here's a good loud one. Okay, that did pick up on the mic. I'm glad about that. If you run in this room, it is like hellaciously loud. But if you're walking on the carpet, it's a little bit quieter. It's like your guy's wearing heels, for God's sake. Oh, it's you, Mike. Funny is if you say, you can change your dialogue, of course, and say no. It's just funny. I can imagine what he said, though.
You go on home ahead of me, alright? I have an errand to run.
Oh, really?
It's your 16th birthday tomorrow, after all. I suppose I'd best find you a present of some sort, eh?
That scene right there probably won't make any sense. I don't know why they even included it, to be honest. I'm sure it won't matter at all anyway. What's even funnier is it actually stays on the screen a lot longer after he's gone too, and it's like, wait, what? Why? There's nothing going on. Why is it still on that screen? Just a fun little bit of information about the game there. Anyway, we're now officially in Chapter 1, The Walk.
Freeze!
That's actually kind of cool if you listen to it, because he actually says Frizz, which is, I think, a fireball spell.
Kaboom!
If I'm not mistaken, Kaboom is a, like, they call it a bomb elemental.
I'm glad that last kaboom woke you, sleepyhead. The next spell I had lined up could have hurt. I bet you're tired from your turn with old Dow yesterday, eh? But you know what today is, don't you? Aye, that it is. Your 16th birthday, lad. The day the Queen will order you to take the Walk of the Worthy, and you'll become a man.
I like to think that if he did talk, he'd be like, well, duh, it's my birthday, you know? He's like, ah, that it is. I like to think that, you know, because, like, I remember they were saying something about in the Legend of Zelda series, the reason why they didn't give Link dialogue is because they kind of wanted to give you the assumption that you're the one talking. But what's funny about that is it's like, however, though, when you think about it, most of the time when they respond to what you say, it's not exactly something that you'd think that they would say to you. Like, for example, it's like, when you talk to the Goron, when you like doing like the sumo wrestling with the iron boots on, and like you kind of give him that like bring it on look, you know, and he's like, oh ho, you know, this is like kind of interesting or whatever the fuck he says, and I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, well, actually, the look he kind of gives him is just like this, like I said, it's like this bring it on look, and he says what he says, and it kind of goes together, but at the same time, you're like, what the hell?
So, don't keep Her Majesty waiting, son. Get yourself sorted and head over to the castle.
What about my gift? What's funny is if you do talk to him, he says. So, he pretty much says the exact same thing. Now, over there is your strong box. Right now, there's nothing in it. There's no point in opening it. If you do click on it, though, it gives you a little bit of information about it. By putting your money in the strong box, you can keep it safe from the monster's greedy clutches. Money can only be deposited and withdrawn in multiples of 1,000 gold coins. So you can't deposit or withdraw anything since there is no money in it. So just close it for now. Now, fun fact. There's nothing in this house that you can search right now. No, there's really not. There's not a single thing that you can look for, so just go ahead and leave when you're ready. If you point the Wii Remote at something that looks interesting, a red arrow appears above it, press the B button, you might find something useful. Saving your game, to save your progress and eventually go to the church in town, talk to Sister Jones, a slight confession. I won't be doing that right now. Now, if you talk to a lot of the people around here, they will be talking about such things as, like, those guys, that guy right there will talk about how he's, like, some kind of, I think he's like an item, like a, no, he's a minigame shop. but also I think he sells an item too. If you go and, you know, like, talk to me, just say, I'm not open right now, though, so you're gonna have to wait. Basically, just saying that that's not required for you to do right now. There's 8 gold coins there. Not like that's very useful. Damn, if you can reach far away. Oh, by the way, I also switched out my, what do you call it? My motion bar, because I've actually found my other one, so I don't know, it didn't seem to make too much of a difference, but yeah, I did want to try it. Let's see, this boy has something interesting, let's talk to him. Queen Quintana never comes to see us anymore. I always loved when she came and told us stories. So any interesting dialogue that I remember reading, I will read to you, but for the most part, a lot of it's just like, hey, this is such and such, but we're not open right now. Hello, Mike. You're looking well again this morning. Not like poor Prince Amless. He seems ever so preoccupied. Just lately, I wonder what could be troubling him. So, there's all that. You can get some interesting dialogue, though, if you come to the pub up here. Also, I think this is a good item. This thing isn't... Yep, 30 gold coins. There's also a very adorable lady right here.
Oh, hello, Mike. Dear me, if you're supposed to be after the castle, you're going totally the wrong way.
And yes, I did say something similar to that in my last recording. That's why I had to say it again, because it only makes sense. I know. I'm sure people will judge me for checking out a babe in a video game, but, you know, I don't really care. If I see a character sprite and it's adorable, I'm going to point it out. I think I've done that in, no, I haven't done that in Evergrace yet. Prison since mom this morning. Nice. This is interesting. What is it, Mike? Your old man hasn't sent you out to buy him booze again, has he?
Nope.
No? Well, I can't serve you, boy. You're not old enough yet. Dude, that's just funny. If you say yes, though, it's kind of interesting, too. The old devil. He certainly hasn't nailed him when it comes to enjoying the drink, eh? Or the ladies. See, that right there, that's proof that it's for teens, though, at the same time. It's like, oh, he enjoys the ladies. I wonder what that means. Ah, hello, Mike. You're looking more and more grown up each every day, you know? In fact, when I saw you holding that sword of yours at the festival, I could have sworn I was watching your father. So that's some interesting dialogue. There's also a map here. It's not important right now, so don't look at it or anything. I think if you just look at it, it says you're not allowed to access it yet. So, yeah. It'll be important for later. Remember, can you do anything with that tree? No, you can't. Hold on, I gotta check something. What is she staring at right now? Just the hills out there? It's kind of cool, actually. What's interesting is you hold the B button, you'll actually move forward, and you can just kind of move left and right with the control pad. It's just if you hold them both together to run. So just a little interesting bit of dialogue, not dialogue, but interesting bit of information for you. You can actually come up here, and go over here as well, and like find this little cave over here. All this is like a, I think it's a graveyard, isn't it? Yeah, it's a graveyard. Herein sleep the dread terrors of a bygone age. When one of almighty strength walks the land, thy end shall they reawaken. Should the almighty one vanquish the terrors, his courage shall be spoken of for all eternity. Is that what... Does any of them else say anything? I don't actually remember this room. I think I might have missed this, actually. So this is an interesting room. It's kind of like... I guess you could call it a graveyard, but it's really not. But, you know, you got this neat little thing here. I can't remember. If you hit A, what does that do? Does it zoom in a little bit? No, okay. Am I going back up the way I was before? Yeah, I am. I haven't gone all the way down here, so... At least not in a while, so I don't remember what's down here. I do like that sound effect, though, because it's like the sound of going downstairs in one of the old games. Whoa, what the hell is this thing? It's a mini Moggy. Hello, Mike. It's perfectly delightful to see you. I'm Mini Moggy, the Mini Metal Lion, and I'd feel like the cat that got the cream if you traveled the world collecting mini medals for me. Oh, okay, that's right. We've got all kinds of lovely presents to swap with you for them. These are the precious presents I can swap with you for those magnificent minute medals. So you kind of got some interesting items here, none that I've ever actually tried using. But, Boulder Dasher, a puny pip which imparts the power to pulverize otherwise impenetrable obstacles. The Yggdrasil Leaf, mystical leaf that resurrects a single fallen ally. Asterisk Hibiscus, makes you megabucks in the midst of melees. Kitten Claw, meows like a moggle in a melee. Poison Needle, capable of felling a foe with a single well-aimed thrust. Now, poison needles were actually used in another one of the Dragon Quest games as well. And what it is it's just like it said, it had a chance of one-shotting a foe, but it was very rare. Gold bar, a solid heavy bar of pure gold. I think you can actually purchase this and sell it for a fuck ton of money. So, I mean, I don't want to say it like that, but it's true. Life Bracer, increases wearer's maximum HP by 15. Other than that, also gives you 5 points of defense. And then Liquid Metal Armor, reduces physical damage by 30%. Basically the best armor, I guess, you can get in the game, but I've never found all 100, I'm sure there's more than 100. I've never found 100 mini medals, so I don't know. Leaving already? Well, I'll be sure to come back if you get your paws on any more of those mesmerizing medals. So you kind of look around here and, you know, he seems to have like all these like treasures and stuff, but you can't look at any of them. Honestly, I don't remember if I ever bought any of that stuff, to be honest, so there's a thing that I probably should have done. I don't even know how many mini medals I have in my thing. I guess I could show you my... Like, I said this in the last one, too, so I'm going to repeat myself a little bit. I could technically show you my other playthrough, but the problem is you would probably miss out on a hell of a lot of stuff, unless I went through and like kind of redid a lot of the stuff. So yeah, there's that. Oh, here's something kind of funny. If you actually look at these boxer shorts, here's the funny thing about them. Boxer shorts, you put your defense down to 1. They don't have any like description or anything, but you could probably, I think you can actually sell them for a little bit of money. I think. I don't remember how you do it, but I think you can. Yeah, you also got a Band of Bravery, which helps, which is kind of cool. I don't think I've ever changed that out from like the game I played. Anyway, there's one more spot that you can go to, and it's down here. That's the chapel where you save your game. But if you come down here, man, I'm wasting your time now. You can open this treasure chest, which has a pouch of replenished shield powder. Basically, just rebuild your shield for you, like repair your shield to full. It's been a good 5 years now since the Deathbringer was defeated. I thank my lucky stars every day that things are peaceful again now. You could have just left it at peaceful again, and it probably would have been more grammatically correct, but oh well. Anyway, you come in here and you see this lady, and she's like, "This is the crypt of the chapel of the Merciful Goddess. Those who gave their lives in the battle against Lifeless 5 years ago are buried here. We can only pray that their souls have enjoyed some relief in the knowledge that he is no longer here to wreak havoc among the living." Again, for a sister, she is kind of adorable, but, you know, that is a thing, so... I have to admit, some of the character sprites are actually well made for a Wii game. And that's what a lot of other people said as well. I'll just go over that real quick. A lot of people were talking, like, a lot of the reviewers I read were saying stuff like, when they spoke about the characters and stuff, they said the characters are really amazing and their dialogue's kind of nice. We'll have to show her face. Okay. Talking about catching a cold. Anyway, let me go show off saving real quick. Even though if I have recording issues, I'm going to regret it because you only have 2 save files. But I'll... Please secure both your sins and high achievements before the great and benevolent goddess. Yeah, sure. Now you notice that there is actually like an autosave feature. So you got nothing to worry about if you do lose power or something while in the middle of your, not a recording, but in the middle of play. So you'd be okay. I successfully recorded your adventure log. Do you plan on continuing your adventure? Now, if you say no, what's interesting is it'll take you back to the menu. But if you say yes, it just continues the game. Now, if you look at, I think it's like Divination or whatever, how you pronounce that, it basically just like cures you of, I think it like it's supposed to cure you of any status ailments or something like that, I'm not entirely sure. No. It tells how much XP you need to level up and all that. Okay, that's what it was. That's right. God. Well, let's head up to the castle real quick, and that's where we'll stop the episode. Right at the castle gates. Man, I'm gonna have to do a 3 or 4 parter, actually, probably, to get the most out of this game. Oh, and in case you're wondering, I most likely will not do a Let's Play of this one unless it's, like, heavily asked for. Because this game, like I said, I've never beaten it. And so, it's one of those games that I'm just kind of playing for the sake of, you know, as I said, showing off. And letting you have your opinion about it. It's all a bit fishy if you ask me. Came all this way after hearing that Prince Annalise is a bit of a looker, but they won't even let me inside the castle. They told me outsiders aren't allowed in, but I reckon they're trying to keep something secret. Sure. Anyway. Oh my god. Anyway, so, when we return to this, we'll go through one more thing. And I think we'll be able to continue on to the walk, and that's when I'll be able to show you the game, its true colors. It's the game's true colors, I should say. And hopefully I'll be able to get all the controls to work the way they're supposed to. I have no promises, but we'll see. Till then, everyone. Bye.